الله رب العالمین بار خلائق اجمعین الصلاة والسلام علی عبده و رسوله حافظ سره و مبلغ رسالاته سیدنا و مولانا ابوالقاسم مصطفی محمد
اللهم صل علی محمد و آل محمد
و علی اهل بیته الطیبین الطاهرین المعصومین اعوذ بالله من الشیطان الرجیم. Brothers and sisters, honorable guests, سماحت حضرت حجت الاسلام و المسلمین حاجی یوسفی سلام علیکم جمیعا و رحمت الله. At the beginning, I would like to extend my sincere congratulations on this auspicious occasion of the Eid of Qadir Khum. Inshallah, I'm gonna speak short tonight in English, and we're gonna be enlightened by Hajjaj Yusufi. But if you allow me, I would start with some poem in Farsi, and then inshallah I continue in English. Salawati muhabbat wa fahmai.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.
Ey Ali, ey irtifa'at ta khuda, bi nahayat, بی کران، بی انتها. ای علی، ای همسر بانوی آب، جلوه حق، اسم اعظم، نور ناب. ای علی، ای خوب، ای تنها ترین، ای ملائک با نگاهت هم نشین. ای علی، ای آفتاب حق سرش، ای قسیم روشنی های بهش. ای تو خورشید نهان در زیر ابر، کوه علم و کوه حلم و کوه صبر. چون تو مردی نیست در این روزگار، هیچ تیغی نیست همچون ذوالفقار. جان ما را کن ز عشقت منجلی، ای فدایت جان عالم یا علی. یا کریم و یا کریم و یا کریم، کاش می شد ما قدیری می شدیم. باز می کردیم بیعت با بهار، مست از عطر نسیم زلف یار. ناگهان در باغ میقات علی، می شکفتیم از کرامات علی. از قدیر خم سبویی می زدیم، در سرات عشق هویی می زدیم. زائر کوی تولا می شدیم، جرعه نوش عشق مولا می شدیم. با نزول سوره سبز قدیر، باز می کردیم بیعت با امیر. باز هم مستیم از جام قدیر، باده می نوشیم با نام امیر. آمده عید ولایت عاشقان، روز اکمال رسالت عاشقان. در قدیر خم بیا کامل شویم، یا علی گوییم و صاحب دل شویم. یا علی گوییم تا بالا شویم، قطره ها ای قطره ها دریا شویم. با علی هم عهد و هم پیمان شویم، هم زبان و هم دل قرآن شویم. یا علی، قرآن ناطق بو تو را، سوره اسمت امام آفتاب. چون که احمد گفت او نور جلیست، بعد من ای عاشقان مولا علیست. صلوات محمد و
محمد و آل محمد.
Brothers and sisters, you know this part of the Quran that inshallah I'm going to recite to you very well, but to remind you of what Allah said in the holy book of Quran, Allah challenges people and said, If you think this Quran is not from God, in Surah Al-Hud, he said, bring 10 chapter like it, 10 surah like it. If you don't think this is from God and is created by man, so you're man, you're human, you bring 10 chapter like it. Then in Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I don't need 10 chapters, bring only one chapter like it. If you think this Quran is not from God, bring only one chapter. And then in Surah Yunus, Allah continues and said, bring one chapter.
One word.
And bring everybody else that can help you with. Bring everybody else. I don't want that one person bring that. Bring everybody that you think that they can help you to bring only one chapter like Quran. So this challenge has not been answered for 1400 years with all the scholars, with all the poets, with all the people who are eloquent in speech. This challenge has not been answered. Now if you go reverse engineer these verses and then say, okay, if you find someone that throughout these 1400 years we could not find one like it or 10 like it, is he appointed by God or not? Imam Ali alayhi salam. If you wanted to realize, if Imam Ali alayhi salam is with the truth and truth with him, and he sent by God, he was appointed by God, throughout these 1400 years, find 10 men like him. 10 men like Imam Ali alayhi salam. 10 men, just one man. Can you, all the historian, everybody can put their heads together, come with only one man throughout the history that is equal to Imam Ali alayhi salam? So similar to Quran, when Imam Ali alayhi salam claimed that he is the speaking Quran, now we know 1400 years later that he was true speaking Quran, because after 1400 years, we could find no one like him. Now that we believe and we have faith that Imam Ali alayhi salam was appointed by God and we could not find like him, let us find out why we need him, like we need Quran. Why do we need to have Imam Ali alayhi salam in our life? Is Quran enough? Or do we need to have someone like Imam Ali alayhi salam and his progeny? Nowadays when you go to get your MBA, you go to business school and you get your PhD, at the very end, when you wanted to graduate, you finish all the books, you have written, you have had all the knowledge available to you, they tell you, in order to be successful, these books are not enough. You need to find some successful man and shadow him, follow him, do whatever he does, then after a while you become close to him, you become like him, and then you can become successful. How many people you know that they have gone through graduate school, they have PhD, they have doctorate and stuff, but when you look at their daily life, they are not so successful. You find somebody who, you know, who has a gas station is more successful than him, because he does not have a role model. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the way that he created us, he wanted us to have role model. The book by itself is not enough. It needs a teacher to teach us. But teach us what? What do we need to learn from Imam Ali alayhi salam? What is the goal? What is the goal? If we wanted to follow Imam Ali alayhi salam, when we say that we are the Shia of Imam Ali alayhi salam, the word Shia means follower. So, if we are the follower of Imam Ali alayhi salam, and we wanted to do exactly, you know, what he did, of course we could never get to the point that we would be exactly like him, but we can get close. And throughout the history, there were people that we know that they are awliya Allah, you know, they will get so close to be similar, like Imam Ali, but never exactly. The ultimate goal is to follow Imam Ali alayhi salam, is to open our heart and have insight. Because with that insight, we become eligible to go to heaven and see what is in there. If we do not gain that insight in this world, according to the verses of Quran, according to the hadith, it's really hard to be deserving to go to heaven. So there is what we have in amongst us in order to kind of relay what I'm trying to say is this. There are lots of things that people see, everybody sees, but not everybody has insight about it. For example, something that every one of you can relate to. You see that, like, the houses become, you know, the housing market booming, and every houses, you know, the prices are going up at one period of time, and in another period of time you see how everything is going down. So this is, everybody can see that and understand that, yes, housing market is good, prices are going up, or housing market is bad and prices is going down. But not everybody knows why. Not everybody has the insight that what are the causes? What happened that the prices are going up or the prices are coming down? Or, for example, in today's society, you will find out that, for example, the youngster, the youth of the society, they are not so interested in religion. Everybody can see that, right? You see, it's very hard for you to bring the kids to the masjid. They don't want to come, and, you know, you have to put extra efforts. But not everybody knows why. That is insight. And that's what. That's why. You know, we read in the Holy Book of Quran that in the hereafter, those people who have disbelief, they tell the believers, they say, can you shine your light so I can also see my way? This is in the Holy Book of Quran. And they say, no, this light you cannot see with our light. It's not a light like a flashlight, it's the insight that they gain in this world. And that's how they can see their way in the other world. Or you see, there are in the Holy Book of Quran, Allah brings an example and says, some people, they tell Allah, they complain. They said, in that other world, meaning in this world, we had eyes. Why you are blind here? So it doesn't mean that in the other world they don't have eyes. They don't have that insight. They did not work good enough to have the insight, so when they go there, they can't see. I don't know if my brothers and sisters, you remember one time, long time ago, I discussed the issue of black and dark matter. So black and dark matter, in summary, nowadays the scientists has proven, and you can go to the site of NASA. Now, if you go to nasa.org and type black matter or dark matter, you're going to see this. This is scientifically proven that this world, the world that we are in it, and the things that we see, what we see is only 5% of what this world is contained of. The world, that the universe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created, we only see 5% of it. 95% of it is hidden from us. We can't see with our eyes. And this is scientifically proven. So when, you know, our fathers, grandfathers, they used to say there are two angels sitting in our right and left shoulder and riding things, and say, oh, I don't see it. Where is that angel? Now, scientifically proven, yes, they are made of materials that we cannot see. And this is from NASA. It's not from, you know, a religious organization. They say 95%, and how they found out? This is how they found it. You know how all the universe is running around, all the, you know, different, like a Venus, all those, they're turning around Earth, Sun, around each other, and still everything is in balance? When they wanted to find the gravity and study the gravity between the different, like between Earth and Sun and Moon and Venus and all those other corals that we have, they found out that according to what they have, according to the formula that they see, the world should not work like this. Everything has to collapse. The gravity of this part of the world and that part of the world, they have to collapse with each other and the world has to be perished. Then they realize there might be something else that we cannot see. They study and they found that, yes, this is what we see, all these moon, sun, stars, earth, everything that we see is only 5%. The other 95% are made of something that we cannot see. And that's what that we need to follow Imam Ali. And you know what Imam Ali alayhi salam, they asked him, they said, the Lord, the God that you worship, did you see him? He said, I don't worship something that I don't see. That doesn't mean with these eyes, meaning with that insight. With that insight, he could see Allah. And we as human can reach that status. All we need to do is to just work hard to become like Imam Ali. That's a role model. Allah said, don't say that, you know, you didn't bring me a role model. The book of Quran was very confusing. No, I have some role model for you, you can follow. You all know the person who wrote the Mafatih, Hashiq Abbas Qumi. One of the great Maraj said that he heard this from him. And they said Hashiq Abbas Qumi was a very pious man. So one time he was in Najaf, in Wadi Salam, which is a cemetery. He heard a really harsh noise, as if they are slaughtering an animal and torturing an animal. So he was wondering, in a cemetery, why they are torturing an animal? So he looked around and he went toward that voice. He found out there are a few people standing there burying a dead body. And that voice is coming from that dead body. But those people who were standing next to him, they couldn't hear it. But he could hear it. That's the insight. Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq and Imam Muhammad Baqir, they had a companion. They said, loud salawat please.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.
Abu Basir was a companion of Imam Muhammad Baqir and Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq alayhi salam. He was blind. He couldn't see. One day in the masjid, Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq alayhi salam was sitting, talking to people. And he said, they were asking about if he can make a miracle. He said, yes, I can. I can disappear myself from people's eyes. So, when you all know that I'm here. But ask anybody who comes from the door if they can see me. So, everybody who came through the door, they said, you know, do you know of Imam Ja'far? They said, no, we didn't see him, you know, today. So these are all the people with eyes. Then Abu Basir came in. They told him, you know, Abu Basir, have you seen Imam Sadiq alayhi salam? He said, yeah, he's sitting right there. And he was blind. So this is what we need to gain, to have insight. This is what we need to have. Thank you so much. Salawati muhabbat bafahmi.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.
Imam Ali alayhi salam said, O God, all my honor is that I can call myself your servant. My honor, everything that I'm proud of, if you put everything together, it comes to the point that I call myself your servant. And all my happiness is that I can call you my Lord. All everything everything that can make me happy, if you put everything together, that comes at the top, that I can call you my Lord. You are the one that I truly love. So make me the one that you truly love. This is Imam Ali alayhi salam. He's saying that the honor for me is that I call myself your servant. By the way, abd, which we translated as servant, but the better translation is devotee, is the highest honor you can reach. I would say, if you put all your questions away, there one question should remain in everybody's life. One question should be in everybody's mind at all time. And that question is, oh Allah, do you call me your servant? Do you call me your devotee? Because if we reach to the point that Allah said, this is my servant, that's it. That's the end. That's the ultimate. And we can see that from the Quran. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He wanted to say that I sent Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, when He said that I sent my, He could say I sent Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, you know, to Mi'raj. He could say I sent my Nabi to the Mi'raj. He could say I sent my Rasul to the Mi'raj. But He didn't say all those things. He said, I sent my servant. Yani, if you translate it in Farsi, that servant and devotee means Aziz Dela, my dearest. Servant means the one who is dear to God. So if we reach to the point that Allah said, you are my servant, that's the point that we should be the happiest of all. Because then that's the point that we truly deserve to go to heaven. That's the point that we truly have that insight to go to heaven. I took some, because one of the things that we say, Imam Ali alayhi salam was so alone, so lonely. People left him alone. You know, I wish I was in Kufa. I wouldn't left him alone. But then when we come to our life, we see, more than those people, we left him alone too. Honestly, just be honest to ourselves tonight. You know, how do we know the great people after they are gone from this world? But what they have left for us. What Imam Ali alayhi salam left for us, the peak of eloquence, the Nahjul Balagha. How many of us have read Nahjul Balagha from cover to cover and understood it? To say, okay, oh Imam Ali, I didn't leave you alone. I read your book, I know what you're talking about. So as a Muslim, these are the things that we have to, if you wanted to follow Imam Ali alayhi salam, these are the things that we have to do. Let me just read some of the portion that I took from Nahjul Balagha in Farsi, and inshallah I will translate it. حضرت می فرمایند شما اکنون مانند پیشینیان خود هستید. You are like those who are dead now, but you are alive. که مجال را از دست دادند و درخواست بازگشت و توبه می کنند. Meaning think about those who have gone to the other world, who are dead, and they're asking Allah to turn them back to life. Because then they repent and they do good. You are that one. Allah has given you the opportunity. You are still, you don't have that opportunity. Allah is not going to say, no, abada, I can't send you back. شما همچون رهگذرانی هستید که از این جهان که سرای پایدار شما نیست کوچ خواهید کرد. بدانید این پوست نازک را تاب و شکیب بر آتش سوزان دوزخ نیست. One of my dear friends, which some of you may know, one time we were talking and he said, I wish somebody could come from the other world and say, what is in other world? I said, Allah said it in the Quran. We don't believe him, and then you want someone else to come and say, and we believe it. So Imam Ali is saying that this skin that we have, it cannot bear the fire of the hell. So be kind to yourself. آیا ندیده اید یکی از شما خاری را که به پایش میخلد و یا لغزشی که او را خونین میکند یا ریگ گرمی که او را میسوزاند چسان مینالد؟ Have you not seen the person who had some injury, how he cries out? پس اگر میان دو تابه آتش قرار گیری و هم بستر سنگ خارا و هم نشین شیطان شوی چه خواهید کرد؟ Imam is saying that you cannot even bear some of the injury in this world. Imagine the injuries that you're going to get in hell. How do you want to bear that part? Then he said, I'll tell you what to do to avoid that. خدا را ای بندگان تا تندرست هستید و هنوز به بستر بیماری نیفتاده ای دستورهای خدا را انجام دهید. تا در گشایش و فراخنای دنیا به سر میبرید تا در گشایش و فراخنای دنیا به سر میبرید و دچار تنگنای گور نشده اید کاری کنید که از این بار گران آزاد گردید. While you have the opportunity, while you're alive, do something. This is your opportunity. Do something that you can relieve yourself from the fire of hell. And then he goes on and said, some of those things to be pious, some of those things if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks you to give interest-free loan, give it to the people. Because as if you're giving that to the God, which God? The God who doesn't need that. Everything in this universe, in the skies, in heavens, on earth, belongs to him. He doesn't need money from you. This is good for you because you're relieving yourself from that fire. So these are the things that, inshallah, brothers and sisters, we need to read the Nahjul Balagha. We need to prove to Imam Ali alayhi salam that we wanted to be with him. You know, one of the things, if today, you know, we're celebrating the Ghadir Khum, who people came and shook hands with Imam Ali alayhi salam. We shake hands with him tonight and say, I pledge my promise to you that I would not leave you alone like those people. I read your book and I follow what you wanted me to do. Because this is how we can relieve ourselves from the prison of the hell. کیست مولا آن که آزادت کند؟ چرا ما به حضرت علی علیه السلام میگیم مولا؟ Why we call him our guardian, our protector, our allies? کیست مولا آن که آزادت کند بند ربیت زپایت وا کند زین جهت پیغمبر والا نهاد نام خود وان علی مولا نهاد
اللهم صل علی محمد و آل محمد.
So when we call مولا علی علیه السلام, he's here to release us from that prison, from the fire of hell. Unfortunately, brothers and sisters, especially you in San Diego, you witnessed that. We Muslim, instead of learning about Imam Ali alayhi salam, instead of introducing him to others and said, this is what I call my master. Because this is, honestly, this is our responsibility to know him and introduce him. Allah put us in this land with a purpose, and that's our mission, to introduce him to the world. But first we need to know him, get to know him ourselves. But what we do, instead of introducing him, we introduce those other that we think that they are not good. There is a very famous sentence said by one of the American scholars. He said, we cannot discover light by analyzing darkness. We cannot turn off all the light, it becomes dark, and we start saying that what is darkness? You know, we start saying, okay, this portion of darkness means this, that portion of darkness. Can we discover light by analyzing darkness? No. we need to know light. If we want to discover it, we need to know the portion that make this light. So we need to know Imam Ali alayhi salam, not the opponent, not this. It's good to know, because when we know the opponent, how strong the opponents are, it shows that how strong the Imam Ali alayhi salam was. But the first step is to learn about him, to introduce him. We spend so much time talking about others and without knowing him the way that we should know him. Hocam, kazın çekat var benim. 10 minutes? 10 minutes, inşallah. Imam Ali alayhi salam in Khutbah 215, Nahjul Balagha, is saying, I swear to God, or by God, if they give me everything under this sky, everything under this sky, and they ask me to torture an ant, just an ant, or take what he is carrying from his mouth, they said, okay, everything under the sky is yours. All you need to do is to just take that small grain of, like, barley that this ant is carrying, take it out from his mouth. He said, I'm not going to do that. That means the whole universe doesn't worth taking and do some injustice to an ant. And now look how we are unjust to each other. How unjust we are to each other. When Imam Ali alayhi salam said this, when he said these sentences, sometimes we take it backward. We say, oh, Imam Ali alayhi salam said, oh, this universe doesn't have any value. He said, dunya bi arzeshe. Dunya arzeshi nadare. Oh. Imam Ali alayhi salam has so much value for this world. So much value. But in comparison, like say, wealth is a good thing. We all wanted to be wealthy, right? We all wanted to accumulate wealth. But compared to the health, which one you prefer? Would you prefer to be very wealthy and ill on a hospital? Or you would prefer to be healthy and, you know, medium class life? So when you compare health to wealth, you prefer health, because you know health is more important than wealth. Then Imam Ali alayhi salam said, justice compared to the whole world, means justice is that important, although this universe is so valuable, but compared to justice is more valuable. And these are the things that, inshallah, we have to think when we come to do something, you know, to gain some worldly material, and we wanted to say, oh, I say this thing and I say that thing, maybe that person doesn't know and I can get some money from it. Or if I do this and I do that, I can get, you know, if I backbite about my colleague, I can get a promotion. Or if I, these are honestly, we are fooling no one but ourselves. We are fooling no one but ourselves. And then Imam Ali alayhi salam categorized people. They said people are in three categories. Those who worship Allah for the benefit of getting to heaven. Because they like to go to heaven, they worship Allah. That's a worship of a merchant, because merchant, he wanted to do something to gain something. And then said the second category are those people who worship Allah to avoid going to hell. Those are the worship of slaves. Slaves, they do things because to avoid the punishment of their masters. There is only one category that they worship Allah for the reason that they found Allah worthy of worship. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the holy book of Quran said, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ عَلَىٰ حَرَفًا. From people and among the people are those people who worship Allah on the side. Meaning that's not their main purpose. They worship Allah on the side. If good things befalls upon them, they're comfortable and they're confident. They said, Alhamdulillah, I worship and Allah gave me some good things. But if a calamity befalls them, if something bad happened to them, they revert to their former ways and losing heart. As soon as something bad happens, they say, oh no, I'm not gonna worship Allah anymore, you know. I've been worshiping Allah and He's not good to me, something bad happened to me. And that's what Allah, as Imam Ali alayhi salam said, those people who worship Allah for the sake of going to heaven or for avoiding hell are in those categories. They worship Allah on the side. Like you have seen, you know, some of you, like myself, I have a daily job to, you know, from 8 to 5, and I have some side jobs, you know, that they do after 5. I don't care about those side jobs if, you know, if they don't go through, you know, some of the deals and stuff. I don't care because I'm still getting my salary. So it's like that you say, okay, my purpose in this world, and on the side I worship Allah. If things happen good, I will continue doing it. If not, then I'll forget it. So inshallah, we should not be like that. Because when our job, our main job is to serve Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's when the real happiness comes to us. The real happiness comes to our heart, the real happiness comes to our families, and so on. And that's what they say, شب مردان خدا روز جهان افروز است. Even at night, they feel it's day, filled with light. روشنان را به حقیقت شب ظلمانی نیست. If you bring Allah truly in your heart, then always is daytime for you. You're always happy. You know, all of us are searching for happiness, and we think that happiness is somewhere outside, but happiness is inside ourselves. We just need to search inside, open our heart. Always remember, humans are like this. If you want to separate yourself from God, from Imam Ali, from Prophet Muhammad, from all the A'immah, is very easy. Very easy. Just think that you are separate from them, and you separate yourself. All you need to do is just think. You say, okay, Imam Ali alayhi salam, I have nothing to do with him. That's it. Human has a good potential to go down the hill really fast. But going up the hill, attaching to these people is really hard. But this is an example I give to the kids in our Saturday school. I say, imagine you are in Iran, standing in those buses that they don't have chairs, you have to stand. This world is like that bus. Everybody is standing and this world is moving. With a little shake, everybody is gonna fall this way or that way. But if you hold on to one of those ropes, this shake just shake you a little bit and then you keep going. Prophet Muhammad, Imam Ali alayhi salam, and the rest of the A'immah are those ropes that if you attach to them, you don't have any worry. No matter the words go this way or that way, you're gonna go to your home very safe. One day, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, was at the masjid. Imam Ali alayhi salam, Hazrat Fatima salamullah alayhi salam, Imam Hussein alayhi salam, they were sitting next to him. At the end of his lecture, Prophet Muhammad raised his hand and said, O Allah, O God, be my witness that I love these four people. O Allah, be my witness, I love these four people. Now tonight, we're gonna raise our hand and say, O Prophet Muhammad, O Allah, you also be our witness, we love these people. We wanna follow them. Because Prophet Muhammad said to Imam Ali, I said, Ali John, بعد از من تو امام امت هستی، مسیری که برای این امت تعیین میکنی به سوی بهشت است. او علی، after me you lead this community and the way that you're gonna take them is toward heaven. در آن نفس که بمیرم در آرزوی تو باشم، بدان امید دهم جان که خاک کوی تو باشم. به وقت صبح قیامت که سر ز خاک برآرم، به گفتگوی تو خیزم، به جستجوی تو باشم. به مجمعی که در آیند شاهدان دو عالم، نظر به سوی تو دارم، غلام روی تو باشم. به خوابگاه عدم گر هزار سال بخسبم، ز خواب عاقبت آگه به موی تو باشم. حدیث روزه نگویم، گل بهش نبویم، جمال حور نجویم، دوان به سوی تو باشم. می بهش ننوشم ز دست ساقی رضوان، مرا به باده چه حاجت که مست روی تو باشم. هزار بادیه سهل است با وجود تو رفتن، وگر خلاف کنم سعدیا به سوی تو باشم. اللهم اینی اسألک و اتوجه الیک به نبیک نبی رحمه محمد صلی الله علیه و آله، یا ابوالقاسم، یا رسول الله، یا امام الرحمه، یا سیدنا و مولانا، انا توجهنا و استشفعنا و توسلنا بک الی الله و قدمناک بین یدی حاجاتنا، یا وجیها عند الله اشفع لنا عند الله، یا ابوالحسن، یا امیر المؤمنین، یا علی ابن ابی طالب، یا حجت الله علی خلقه، یا سیدنا و مولانا، انا توجهنا و استشفعنا و توسلنا بک الی الله و قدمناک بین یدی حاجاتنا، یا وجیها عند الله اشفع لنا عند الله. صلوات محبت به محمد،
اللهم صل علی محمد و آل محمد.
بنده عذرخواهی میکنم که در حضور آقای یوسفی وقت شما عزیزان رو گرفتم. سوالات خیلی خوبی دفعه پیش پرسیده بودید، من جواباشو آماده کرده بودم. انشالله دیگه امشب از حضور آقای استفاده میکنیم، در دفعات بعد انشالله در خدمت شما هستم. از جناب حجت الاسلام و مسلمین آقای یوسفی دعوت میکنیم تشریف بیارن با صلوات محمدی شما.
اللهم صل علی محمد و آل محمد.